Or D, get a lift from a mate and hope for the best when they fly home?
What about A, for A1 Airport Parking?
At A1 Airport Parking, get 2 days for $25, 3 days for $34, or get 7 days parking for just $69. And at just 5 minutes from the airport, they'll get you there in time for your flight and pick you up when you get home. Show your footy or sporting club membership anytime you park and get 10% off. A1AirportParking.com.au.
Program sponsor.
And we're back here at the Vermont Recreation Reserve to get the second half underway. It's a 4-point lead to the Eagles that are out there wearing yellow and, what is it, no, purple and gold, I think purple they refer to
it. The violet crumbles.
The violet crumbles. And Buxton gets the tap down for the Eagles into the path of Luke McComb. He pumps it inside 50. Mark not taken by Purdy. Perry was cast in the role of a rover but couldn't quite do the work required to bend down below his knees to pick the bloody red thing up.
Are they still around, Ray? Violet crumbles? I thought they were obsolete.
They're still around, mate.
Pollywaffles, I think Raymond. Raymond goes after those ones. Stoppage at half forward.
I'm more of a crunchy man.
I don't eat chocolate, it's very bad for you. Up goes the Sharon at centre half forward. Smart work by Parker. The old the Falcon on Adam Parker. Picked up by McComb.
Like
he couldn't
seal.
Quite get an arm free. It was a very, very strong tackle laid by that man, Nathan Gordon.
He looked like a seal, Parker, with balancing the ball on top of his head. That goes down as a stat, surely, Soupy.
So we've got 10 metres in the direction of Baldwin's goal. Parker is wrapped up immediately by Gilchrist, and it looks like he's done a knee or hurt himself with Parks. Gilchrist helps him up. Might be a bad one. A bit of a stunned silence around the crowd.
Yeah, he might have hurt himself there.
Gee, I'll have to start not taking player stats. I swear I'm cursing them. Whoever's I pick either gets injured or has a shocker.
Just seemed like to Rennie with it was a bit of a dumping sort of tackle. They've done that to each other all day. Looks like it could be a kneecappy type.
He's certainly in trouble with that left knee there. Yeah, let's hope it's not a very bad injury because he's a great player, Adam Parker.
Is that patella tendon out of place? No, it's not. It's
maybe it looked like it was that sort of initial injury, though. Having done one myself, it tends to feel like you've been hit on the knee hard with the kneecap dislocation.
If not long term, you wouldn't see him coming back today the way they're carrying him off at the moment.
Absolutely not. It looks structural and it looks bad.
He's a very tough player, too, so you certainly know he's badly injured.
Absolutely, yeah.
But it did look, unfortunately, though, that sort of reaction of maybe the kneecap just slipping out because the way he sort of initially went to it was if he'd been hit hard on the knee. And that is how it feels. I did it playing cricket, Raymond, and I thought the cricket ball had hit me very hard on the bear before they said the ball was nowhere near you.
We wear pads these days, Aaron.
Yeah, I know. Well, that was the thing. They said to me, well, I don't know how it got past your pad.
There's the ball up at centre-half forward. Buxton to McComb of the Robbie variety, I believe that was.
Maybe Alana can get a word on him. Thanks.
Down there, thanks to chiropractic betting, of course. Meeson and Buxton. No real decisive winner of the tap. Cross just bats it forward. Gordon, that's exciting. The old don't argue. Then the handball to Lockie Bain, who goes to Marco Regan. Is that going to stay in? It does. It's a good mark taken by Goebbels. Hard up against the boundary line. It's a pretty easy pocket for the right footer here at Vermont. It opens up nicely, Raymond.
I saw about five guys kick goals from there in the reserves game.
Last game of footy, kickable. I played for the mighty Templestowe Football Club. I jagged one from just about here.
Since when have Templestowe come and played Vermont?
We played a final here against Boronia.
Oh, that'd be right, I was going to say.
And it was right here.
On the main against Vermont.
On the pain of 45, and it sailed through a post tight. And we'll see Jeff Goebbels do the same thing here. Top of the left-hand goalpost. We'll bring that back nicely, but it's come off the outside of the boot and never really looked like going anywhere near the goals. It's out of bounds on the full. All that for nothing, Raymond.
You put the Seymour Moz on him then,
absolutely,
mate.
Absolutely
really
did.
You build it up to nothing.
Special kind of play to put one from that through from that position.
Now, Parker's walked from the gates to the bench all but with a limp, but he's putting some weight on it, which he wasn't able to do a couple of minutes ago.
Isn't Dyson Baker just cutting a very smooth figure through the Vermont crowd here at the Eagles' Nest this afternoon? He makes his way back around to the commentary box. The ball's at half forward. We'll have a stoppage. Meeson gets a tap down to Gilchrist, who releases Cross, who's high up and under kick. Isn't going to travel the required distance. No mark taken anyway. Cassie tries to get around one tackle. Just knocked across there by Howard. In the direction of a teammate. That's Neil. Handball's back to Connor McCafferty. He's got a little bit of toad as Connor McCafferty puts it under his arm. At the centre half back, Emily. Handball's back to Kerry. He tries to get around O'Regan. He does that successfully. Goes to McCafferty inboard.
Oh, well,
it's smart footy, but the execution by McCafferty is no good. McComb, Howitt, cross tackles him. We'll have a ball up at centre half back. Dyson Baker.
You know, whatever you said about me, I can watch back on the replay.
It was nothing.
He just called you a smooth operator, mate.
Very smooth operator. Speaking of which, McCafferty handballs to Neil. Handballs back. Emily ducks his head. That should be prior opportunity. Cross lays the tackle. Umpire, you've got to pay holding the ball here.
Oh,
that's exactly
theatrical.
What he does. And Sean Cross will take the free kick. It's centre half forward. Either side yet to put a score on the board. We've gone 5 minutes in this third term.
I suppose a positive thing here for Vermont is Parker's gone to the bench. He hasn't gone to the rooms.
Cross just pumps it to the top of the square. Big pack forms. Fist down to the front. McComb. All numbers are going to be with Vermont, but it's a good kick. Mark dot taken by Crocker. Cross. All down now in the hands of Weatherald. Left will kick inside 50. No mark taken. And we're going to have a stoppage situation finally in the forward pocket. The umpire lets them play. That should be a free kick. Going the way of the Tigers. But too high. No, the umpire didn't see it. Dyson, you can take over.
Sure. It's a solid 6 minute session, not bad.
It was a labour. The ball didn't go anywhere. There was turnovers everywhere.
Such has been the way this game's gone so far, as once again on cue, Gilchrist wraps up Cam Hewitt.
Much like the 1v2 game we saw last night.
Dyson. Yeah, lack of excitement in both contests. Meeson punches forward, ball goes nowhere, held up. There was Schneider. So ball still about 40 metres out from goal. The Tigers thrown up once again, Meeson down. Schneider's first to meet it, got caught, absolutely clotheslined. So he'll win the free kick. Now a chance for a bit of clean disposal. Though I might have asked too much. We'll see how this kick comes from Schneider.
St Kilda have piled on 8-2 in the third term to take a 6-goal lead into three-quarter time. Timmy Membry, the former Sydney Swan, has got 5 for the Saints.
Great mark by Buxton. It's centre wing. Kicks up further afield to Perry.
Kick.
He just went up.
That was too easy. Yeah. Marked it unopposed.
Pendlebury didn't even bother to fly. Kick came in towards forward 50, and Milhoist and Few, everyone
Best.
Flew,
yeah.
But Best sitting over the back managed to take the mark all by himself, and he can go back and line up from a 45-degree angle to extend the lead for the Vermont Football Club.
The two Baldwin defenders then, they completely mistimed that mark, and Best, he didn't even get off the ground. He just stood at the back and marked it.
Jake Best missed one earlier today and has done exactly the same thing. It's almost a carbon copy of what happened earlier in the earlier in this game in the first term. Moves Vermont onto 5-8-38, Baldwin 5-3-33. 8 minutes gone, third term here on AFL Game Day.
Parker again just walked up, but he looks in a lot of trouble with that knee. He's still limping heavily.
Kick out from Weatherald. Nice work there from Davidson to create a contest. Under a lot of pressure there was Gordon trying to work it out. Met with a high tackle there from Purdy. Umpire said play on. Wadley gang tackled by two. Wright brings him to ground. Right in front of the Vermont coach's box. Emily copped it from the Vermont coach's box then. Interesting to hear what was said on that occasion. Purdy playing the role of a rover. Inside forward 50. No real marking option there. Good work from Pendlebury to try and punch it away. First to meet the ball there was Crocker. Trying to get it away now. Handball came out, found McConnon, put himself under a lot of pressure. Emily tucked up hard, wrong side of the boot, and has settled that straight through the middle. So finally Vermont get the goal, and they move on to 6-8-44. Baldwin 5-3-33. Almost 10 minutes played in this third term.
He hasn't done enough of that today, Kyle Emily. That's what he's good at. He gets out the back of packs and uses the footy well. He's the guy he's lifted in this third term. He's got a little bit more possessions around the back of the packs. You can't leave him open, though, because he does use the footy well.
It's not the best exhibition of football we're witnessing here today, but I tell you what, boy, it's a very tough contest. That ball is hot.
9 minutes of pure stalemate and Vermont get an important goal against the Breeze, and they're going inside 50 again, this time courtesy of McComb, who finds McConnon, a centre-half forward, who got a little bit too overzealous with his kick, went straight into the man on the mark. Penderbury's dumped in a tackle by Best. That ball's stolen by Neil, who kicks back in board. And Cam Howard.
That was play of the day.
Cam Howard was going to run into an opening goal, but that was out of bounds.
The crowd wasn't
that
too
was
happy,
out of bounds.
The crowd on this side of the ground not happy at all with it. Not that they could see anything.
Absolutely not. He's Purdy, third man up, Best. First one to get hands on it. Sitting on his number there is Cross.
Just look at the number, the amount of numbers that are around that contest, boys. Look, there. Both sides just need to get a couple of little outriders, just 10 metres off the contest.
The look of modern footy, Raymond, 100 blokes inside, forward, 50, and look at Kobe McConnon, just try and cut his way through. He can't quite find the space he was after. The ball's picked up by Schneider, whose handball over the top only went as far as Crow, who gets it to Weatherald, who pumps it out the centre-half back. That's some sharp work there by Matty Lee. They're off and running. Here's JJ Penny. Takes a bounce. Inside forward 50. Kick on the left foot.
Sack.
It's no good. He was inspired by himself, JJ Penny, and stuffed it up. There's a behind.
But that, as you said, it was stuffed up because it was the pressure put on by the Vermont defenders. They just did not give up the chase.
It was very good transportation of the football, though. It was quick.
Yeah. That was great play from Kirby McConnon as well, running the gauntlet. Just couldn't get a handle on it.
Boundary.
That's the difference at the moment. You look at Vermont, stalemate for 5 minutes, Baldwin, they've just managed to run that clean disposal. As this kick goes out of bounds right in front of the Bendigo Bank scoreboard, we'll cross boundary side thanks to chiropractic betting, Esmond Aponzo.
Pick up bet on Adam Parker, his eye stop on the knee. Not a good look to come back this afternoon.
Done for the day, Adam Parker. Aaron Kirkby wrote her in tears at the moment. President, of course, of the Adam Parker fan club.
And the vice president, and the treasurer, and the junior vice president.
Questioned the AFL senior coach this morning when Brett Moore walked past us about just have a look at Adam Parker, and he's played all of it 2.5 quarters.
He was still better than a couple of blokes he picked out of him.
All righto.
So, Rennie Watts grabs it out of the ruck, tries to kick around the body, grab a little kick, just goes in on the outside of the point post, and we'll have another ball in.
The big man Watts there, Renwick Watts, he's had a pretty quiet day. I think that for Baldwin to get up, he's got to start getting into the contest a bit more.
We do need that improved Renwick factor. There's two Renwicks out there, of course.
Only side in the Eastern Football League, probably the only side in the country.
Only side of the EFL with two Renwicks.
Crow had about three grabs at it, finally got the handball away. Weatherald kicks inside forward 50, darting pass just outside the paint.
Great vision.
Finds
there.
Cross.
He needs to kick this.
40 metres out directly in front.
He needs to kick this. He's been poor by foot today, Sean Cross.
Well, he should get the distance. It's just a matter of accuracy, I would say.
It was lovely.
Wins at his back.
Lovely locks flowing in the breeze.
Sean Cross to cut the margin back to 4 points. Kicks stayed left. Distance was an issue. Accuracy was 3-for-1 behind. 5-5-35 Baldwin. Vermont 6-8-44. 12 and a half minutes gone. Third term here on AFL Game Day.
Let's go to Grant Soupy Campbell for the stats that have mattered so far in his third term. Thanks to Choose Tap, of course.
Baldwin leading the inside 56-3. Clearances 6-4 the way of Vermont. Contested possessions, Vermont leading 13-9.
Make sure you download the free Choose Tap app today. Be smart and Choose Tap. Yarra Valley Water, of course, great sponsors of the Eastern Football League. There's Shane Davidson with the kicking in duties for Vermont.
Kick.
Goes to himself and thumps it long down in the line. I think Phillips got a bit of a shove.
Holding
against Meeson. It's going the way of Joel Perry.
It's great to see our listeners and our viewers tune in from everywhere. The views are great from the 15th floor of the Hampton on Hilton here in Warsaw in Poland. As soon as the broadcast is over, Brash is heading to Amsterdam to do some more pole dancing Dutch style.
The 15th floor, geez, that great height.
He's
fresh.
Splashed out there.
Clearly spending a lot of the money he's earned while on the AFL media team, that's for sure.
Falls with Weatherald at centre-half back. And Crow drops a sitter in the middle of the ground. But he's got enough time and space to mop it up. Goes to Weatherald. Another sitter drop this time. That was by De Souza. Now a bouncing ball at centre-half forward through the arms of O'Regan, who's pleading with the umpire for some sort of free kick that wasn't there. On hands and knees is Timmy Johnson, the skipper of the Vermont Footy Club. That was a massive cock-up by the Baldwin boys. Two absolute sitters dropped, and then possibly a shot on goal gone begging.
That's probably the one area they've really missed with Barker out, also with Hughes and Broadhurst missing, is De Soysa just probably hasn't stood up as well as
Ray, there's a lot of play standing still out there.
Yeah, there certainly is. Look, everyone's waiting for someone else to do something instead of getting in there and doing it yourself. But as I said before, I would just like to see a couple of players stand off the contest and wait for the ball to be dished out to them.
Every player on the ground is within, I reckon, 50 metres of each other.
Gordon, third man up, Kyle Emley, who cuts his way through a pack and just dumps it out wide. We'll have a boundary throw in. So, Stoppage City, everyone all, Tackers football, Dyson back, everyone all up in each other's business.
One would help, boys, that Wayne Brasher's not over there in Poland trying to describe this game to some local Poles over there, because you know, everyone's just around it, as Dyson said.
Absolutely. It's not very pleasing on the eye, this contest.
I was just looking down here at Brad Neal getting a bit of work done, I'm assuming for cramp, and I just keep thinking how many of these players have actually done the work, because it seems to be a lot of standing around going on at the moment.
Come on, Dice, it's not
questionable. Shane Davidson at centre-half back, tucks the footy under his arm, he's off and running, does the old 1-2 with Cam Howard. The kick inside 50 is a shocker. Straight in the arms of Chris Pendlebury. McConnon was streaming towards goal. No side wants to gain ascendancy in this game. There's Gottliebson at centre-half back. Swings out right to Renwick Gilchrist. It goes to Liam Fraser on the hands. Out wide to centre-half forward. There's Gordon. Takes the mark for Baldwin. Low flat ball inside 50. Goebbels on the lead. Bounces off his chest. JJ Penny on hands and knees. Goebbels again. Just gets it forward. De Soysa. Penny steals the ball and runs into an open goal. The stalemate is broken. JJ Penny. There's the excitement that they needed. The chiropractic betting goal of the day is right there, folks, I reckon. And there's a good goal. 6-5-41. The Tigers go to Vermont. Stay on. I think they're on 7-6. I'm not quite sure. The scoreboard always changes. 6-8-44 they go to. So 3 points of margin in favour of the Eagles.
Yeah, look, in the last 5 minutes, I just get the feel that Baldwin, although they haven't been clean with the ball, they're at least trying to run the ball and trying to get the game open out, because they would much rather play it on their terms out in the open. And the last 5 minutes or so of Baldwin, I think, has been very good.
The turnover, Davidson inside 50. How costly is that?
I think that was probably more the reading of play by Pendlebury. Shows his great asset. There was two running back towards goal. Pendlebury positioned himself brilliantly well.
Rennie Watts gets the tap down and then just tries to kick it away. Emily was first to meet it, got met with a bit of pressure. Now got it away to McComb. Back to Emily. Inside forward 50 with a bouncing ball. No one really there to meet it. Weatherald was the first one there. And immediately he's gang tackled by about five Eagles and going nowhere.
That disposal going inside 50, probably the last quarter and a half of everyone, has been tripe. They just cannot hit a target.
So ball about 40 metres out. The Vermont goal. That came out. Good work off the back of the pack there, Sanfilippo. His disposal wasn't all that threat. Same could be said for McConnon's. Now got Leibson, tries to get it away. Tried to take on too many. Lucky not to be penalised. Pendlebury having to work through a couple. Great work, and now poised through Milhusen. Back to Gottliebson, just got it away into the centre of Vermont Recreation Reserve. Eagles there to meet it, but Goebbels was too smart. Inside forward 50 off the boot of Matty Lee. Bouncing ball into an empty goal square. Which one will this lead? What a goal from Matty Lee! 70 metres out into an empty goal square, bounces through, and Baldwin are in the lead.
Which one will this way? It's wonderfully called by you, Dyson Baker.
What Baldwin have got now, they've got players who are prepared to run through the middle of the ground, and it's happened on the last two occasions where they've kicked it to the centre of the ground. The player coming out from the forward line has got options running past him straight into the open goal.
Again, though, it starts with Pendlebury. I mean, Gottliebson was in real trouble there. Pendlebury, again, cool head, breaks a couple of tackles, and good effective handle.
Just his composure is fantastic.
I'm hoping this one busts wide open now and we get to see some free-flowing play. And guess who out of the centre again? Robbie McComb inside forward 50 for the Eagles. And Joel Perry's met this one the best. Casting the roll of the rover. Left foot kick from the former room to the wrong side of the stick.
He just had too much time
He didn't want to kick it on the left. And
He did everything right, though. He stopped and he paused and he thought, yeah, I've got to kick it on the left. So off I go.
Finish was no good. They moved to 6-9-45. The Tigers are 7-5-47. 2 points the margin. Weatherald, he's stepped over the mark. That Cardinals,
the coach killer.
That Cardinal sin, they call it, Dyson. Not sure which Cardinal. Not George Pell, I hope.
That was great watching Joel Perry, though. Just the fear of the thought that I'm going to have to kick this on my left foot.
Yeah. He was waiting for Best to come to him.
And here's the work from the top of the square. 9 times out of 10, we see a rush behind in this situation. This time we see a clearing kick for Big Rod Crow. The reverse corkscrew punt up to the middle of the ground. Kennedy gets the handball across to Bain. All of a sudden, they're inside 50. And Goebbels has got to run into an open goal. Goebbels has got to kick number 4. And the lead for the Bowman Tigers is going to stretch. That's 8 points.
They've got to do something about this, the Eagles, because what Baldwin are doing, they blaze out a defensive 50 to a contest, and the wave of Baldwin players, they're always hitting the front of the contest first, and they're the ones running back towards goal.
Well, there's been a pattern with the last 2 goals. They've been exactly the game. What I would think I'd be doing if I was down there on that back line of Vermont, someone's got to stay at home, mate, about that centre-half back position. Maybe even forget your man. Let's cut off that flow that's going down there through the corridor.
They've kicked 3 in a row, the Tigers, and all in that sort of break back over the back style. And Jeff Goebbels, isn't he proving to be the difference in this game so far? He's kicked 4 of the best. He's had a hand in a couple of others. He's proving why he's a match winner up forward at the moment. All of a sudden, the margin is out to 8 points, Dyson Baker.
Sure is.
And the big man Watts in the centre now. He's at least making a contest out of it.
Just ticking into time on 2 in the third term on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard.
Trying to get it away there was Watts. Emily, at the fall of the ball, managed to grab it. Nice work here from Wright. Gives his handball away. Finds Gilchrist. Now out to Crow on the commentary side wing. Gives to Cross. Short chip kick over the top. Yeah. Dangerous position. Punch came from the back. Nice chance to work it out. Milhoisen. Gilchrist loads up from 50 out. Ball winner on the trot here. That's 4 straight now. And they take a commanding lead as we tick into the final moments of this third term here on AFL Game Day. And just like that, it's now out to a 14-point lead. 9-5-59, Vermont 6-9-45. Grant Campbell, two-stat match stats.
One area Bourne are really getting on control is the uncontested possessions, which they lead 37-18 for the quarter. And that's now Bourne kicking 3 goals from their last 3 inside 50s.
You were spot on, Seymour, 5 minutes ago when you called that this game is going to break open, because Baldwin, they've certainly broke it open in that last 5 minutes.
Well, they've done what they've had to do, and that's take advantage of kicking with this breeze in the third term. Obviously, the Eagles are going to come home with it. It's not a horrendously strong one, but this buffer now, Aaron Kirkby Radio, of 14 points, it's handy.
Just about the biggest of the match creeping up there now, but Bourne are running twice as fast forward as Vermont are running back, and it's becoming a real problem. You see it again here.
Here's the Tigers on the march once more. Taylor Gilchrist, the high kick inside 50. Goebbels crash the pack. Oh. Right foot kick around the corner. The opportunistic goal from Lockie Bain. 5 on the trot for the Tigers in the blink of an eye. This game is almost out of reach for Vermont. 21 points. It is a match high margin now. 20 points it is, sorry. 6-9-45. The Eagles 10-5-65. The Baldwin Footy Club, and they have stamped their authority on this clash.
It's the last 10 minutes once again, but that, as Soupy mentioned, they're getting the ball on the outside and being able to use it cleanly, the Tigers, and it's becoming a real, real problem. Because even when Vermont are getting the clearances off half-back, they're getting clean possession.
They're finishing.
And you go back 10 minutes ago, they tried everything. They were still fumbling and all that, but they still tried to push the ball forward. And all of a sudden, the ball's starting to fall their way, and they got that run.
They're finishing as well. So 10-5, plays 6-9, and that's the difference so far.
Three-quarter time, can't go quick enough, and it might be good here for Vermont, but they get the clearance. Great work from Emily. Finds Perry, who can't mark. Wright gives his handball away. Crow under a lot of pressure. Milhoisen. Now to Gottliebsen. Trying to run through there was Purdy. Overran it. 35 metres out from goal. Crow just tries to rush it. Didn't get enough of a toe on it. Now Gottliebsen feverishly puts it over the boundary line and out of bounds.
Joel Perry, you've got to take that mark.
He's got a mark.
That's a beautiful
kick.
Lead.
The kick was perfect. Hands up. Ball to the deck. That's the difference in a game like this. Not good enough from your star full forward.
They look a bit slow at ground level in the forward line, Vermont, at the moment.
25 out, Phillips taps it down, but only finds Baldwin jumpers. Crow taps up, nice work to meet the ball. Gordon gives away to his captain in Gilchrist, who turns it over. Very rare error there from Gilchrist. Gives to Davidson, Wadley, Emily from 35, darting ball.
Needs to kick that.
In between the big one and the little one, 3-for-1 behind. 6-10-46, Baldwin 10-5-65. 24 minutes gone, third term.
They've had one more scoring shot, the Eagles, and they trail by 19 points. Bad kicking is bad footy, Ray Baird. They've been saying it for as long as you've been alive.
Well, Dyson Baker's been telling you that for the last fortnight.
It's my bugbear at the moment.
Bad kicking is bad footy.
That's Kyle Emily too. He has to kick that.
And right now, their work in front of goal just stinks.
Three-quarter time, Montrose 5-11. Trail, Noble Park 7-9.
Is Rod Crow in the back pocket?
Oh
that is tough.
Howard.
He's out cold, Cam Howard. And Jeff Goebbels just struck back the position. I've got this one, fellas. That's tough. He's up.
Just took the wind out of him, I think, there, Cammy Howard.
Boundary.
It's crossed down boundary side. Thanks to chiropedic betting. Alana Coleman in position eight.
Yeah, it's really a contrast between the two back lines at the moment. The Baldwin back line's really composed and not giving away any free kicks and managing just to keep handballing it around and bringing the ball out of defence nicely, whereas Vermont are starting to look a little shaky and really caught underneath the ball.
Is Howard not missing a beat on the bottom of that pack only moments after being knocked out cold? He was on a stretcher, in my mind. I had him out for the rest of the game. And he bounced straight back up. Davidson.
Oh, he had him lined up
Davidson. Connor McCaffrey, that was sharp. They need a mark inside 50. Phillips does well to body his opponent in right out of position.
This game, it's just gone up a couple of notches. It's going to break open soon. I thought Shane Davidson was going to put someone in hospital then.
Even Phillips, I think, landed a few
elbows. Free kick to buckets. Ryan Phillips.
Has to kick the goal.
And he does.
That'll be. Can we give him player of the day for that?
Back, Luke McComb. Trying to take the advantage.
He's kicked that from Canterbury Road.
I tell you what, Steve Cochran had the sniper out. If that was going to be played advantage and he missed that.
Luke McComb's kicked the goal, but Cam McComb's standing next to the umpire and giving him heaps why it was an advantage.
Now that the dust had settled, it's going to be a free kick to Ryan Phillips, who copped an errant elbow to the back of the head from big Renrick Watts.
How important is this kick, boys? Because we're coming to the end of the quarter. He has to kick a goal.
Cut the margin. It'll be back to 13 points if this one goes through. And it'll give the boys a bit of belief. Hang on, we can put one through from the set shot.
He's pretty good kick.
They've been rubbish in front of goal this afternoon. He's got one next to his name. Ryan Phillips out to the right-hand side. It's not even going to trouble the scorers. McComb is going to rove that ball. They've turned something into nothing here, Vermont, and they've been good at that all day. Wadley's been tackled. Schneider's been tackled as well. No one can get a kick away. McComb. Handball out to Phillips, who induces the high contact. The umpire is wise to it,
surely,
and it penalises the Eagles.
Well, they haven't paid the last one either, so...
The free kick's coming back.
That probably I can understand a bit more, though, because it was a blaze. He wasn't...
And it's going the way...
It wasn't a controlled kick.
It was five shots on goal. I mean, I know they're all snaps around the body, but that's five plus the shot on goal that Vermont haven't even tried
Big
to...
Johnny Leeson, the kick to right goal. I'm light-headed, Dyson Baker. This game has gone up a notch. Yeah. It's outrageous here at Vermont Recreation Reserve.
Crow at half-back. Told to move it on. No, told to come over his mark.
Oh, that's really important.
he's got to kick it down the line now.
It really annoys me.
No, he's crisscrossed it.
We've gone 27 minutes, Dyson. We can't be too far away from the three-quarter time siren.
Ball in the arms of Taylor Gilchrist. Dangerous kick, but it finds its target in Tregear. He's got a teammate further afield in Bain. This one will sit up and bounce for him beautifully. I'll tell you what, it's nice playing with an oval-shaped ball. Gives back to Wright. Short chip kick back over the top. It's managed to find Rennie Gilchrist. 40 out, darting pass. Jeff Goebbels all by himself. Corey Cassidy was 15 metres away when he took that mark.
I just don't know how Rennie Gilchrist gets that much space. He was all on his own. He had time, pick it up, turn
it's
around.
Work rate. He was over here 30 seconds ago.
Someone's got to be running near him at least, though. There was no one even within 20 metres.
Parker was going with him from the first half. Alas, Goebbels to line up for number five. Extend the margin. And I tell you what, this is the genuine 12-point play, the one that they miss and the one that we get for Baldwin.
Going for goal at number five.
Jeff Goebbels at the 28-minute mark of the third term here on AFL Game Day. Comes in, sends it on the right boot, and makes the goal umpire work through for one behind. 10-6, 66, a 20-point lead in favour of the Baldwin Football Club. Vermont 6-10. 46. That pretty much says it all so far. 28 and a half minutes gone. Third term. EFL Game Day, whether you're online on www.efl.org.au or listening to us live on 98.1 Radio Eastern.
Davidson is waiting to retrieve the ball. He's going to do the kick-in duties from full back. of movement up ahead. He's got McComb leading in a bit of space, but he kicks to himself, gets himself the plus three Dream Team points and goes long to a pack.
Good
and
mark.
A strong mark taken by Sammy Tezoiza.
Quiet this afternoon.
Has been. Goes out wide.
Is that Gilchrist again?
I think it is Taylor Gilchrist. Left foot kick inside 50. Jeff Goebel's in there laying a strong tackle on Cam Howard. Ball up at centre half forward for Baldwin, who have had the run of it in this quarter. Howard releases a teammate who probably unlucky not to get a free kick for a push in the back. That was Preto, who wouldn't be surprised if he misses next week with pneumonia. Hasn't gone near the football this afternoon. Here's Rennie Gilchrist though. The left foot kick around the corner to the top of the square. Is that a mark on the goal line? I think it is.
Yeah, I'm both paid it.
It's been paid. Christian Sanfilippo in a Vermont sandwich. He's taken a mark right on the goal line.
Has a 10-metre rule apply, Dyson.
Does it? Yep. No.
No.
Runs around on the right boot. Oh. Doesn't get anywhere near it. So that was a...
That's one kick that I reckon's genuinely got worse.
Anti-climax.
In the last 15 years.
The
yeah, kicking around the body.
The Czech side from South Australia.
I think it's genuinely got worse.
Well done, Bruce.
Ball will be in the hands of Davidson at the restart. Waiting for it to come back. Now he's assessing his options. No one on the mark. There's... JJ Penny works and puts the pressure on. Great mark taken from Tezoiza.
The ball's dropping short and he's the only one that seems to realise it.
JJ Penny under a bit of pressure. Davidson now gets it away. Johnson hard up against the boundary line. This one will go right to the line.
Ooh.
And right. Heard footsteps then. Having said that, I wouldn't want to go up against Ryan Phillips.
There's a three-quarter time siren. And the Baldwin Tigers, well, they flex their muscles in that term. Five unanswered goals. There's a bit of a dust-up as we head into the last change, but the score here is 10-6-66 Baldwin, 6-10-46 Vermont. The Eagles coming home with the breeze in the last term. Don't go anywhere. This is EFL game day, all thanks to the pancake parlour.
Amy, I've got some weekend goals.
Like what?
First, wake up around lunchtime.
Oh, yeah.
Second, go into Pancake Parlour and get one of their traditional breakfasts because it's served till 5 p.m. every day.
You got to go to Pancake Parlour for your weekend goals, yeah.